Hi everyone. So let's talk about Docker containers in depth. So Docker ps-a will give you active and exited containers. Like some containers were running, but now they have exited. So they are not like inactive containers. Okay. So this is the basic command. So what we are doing whenever we are running an image, it creates a container. This is a thumb rule. So whenever you run the image, it will create a container. Now you can just stop, start, restart, or remove that container from command. So this is another architecture from, this is not my copy. I copied it from nordcapis.com. So this actually explaining the same picture which we were talking, that there is a client, Docker remote API or Docker command line client. From command line client, we are actually passing different commands like Docker pull, Docker build, Docker run. And this is the host operating system. So this host operating system, which is running the Docker daemon, will process all these commands. So if you hit Docker pull, so it will check, do I have that locally? No. So it will pull that from the Docker hub. So pull is represented in yellow. So just check the yellow dots and it's a flow. So it will pull that image from the registry and it will keep that in the images. It will list that in the images. Now in the green, whenever you are doing run, Docker run command, so it will just run that image and it will create the container. So green dots from here to here to here. Okay, then Docker build. Build is happening from the Docker file. So on the client, if you have a Docker file, then these purple dots are showing that Docker build. So Docker build is reading the Docker file and creating the image. That's it. Docker daemon process will read all the instructions of the Docker file and it will create the image for you. Now that image, if you run the Docker run on that image, it will create a container. Okay, this is the Docker architecture again. Okay, and this is how the Docker daemon process is working. So here we are building the image, and on top of the Docker daemon process, we are creating the different containers, we are installing the applications on them, and then we are again pushing that image to the Docker hub. So pull push mechanism is like a pull push which is happening on GitHub and happening on Docker hub, both look like same. We pull the image from the Docker hub, we build it, we get the container, we play our application, now we stop the container, we do some changes and we do push that image to the Docker hub in the Docker registry. Okay, so this is, we have already seen how the Docker image look like. Now, what is the life cycle of the Docker container? This is not that complex. So Docker run, I'm talking about Docker file here. So Docker run, it will create the container, right? It will create the container. So whenever you do the start command, it will start the container. Container is running. Now you can do a Docker restart, Docker pulls, and all these things. So this particular is talking about Docker container. This is talking about Docker daemon process, where you are actually killing, starting, restarting, or pulling the Docker container or Docker daemon. Okay. So whenever you do Docker create, you created a Docker file and you are doing a Docker start. So you are actually starting the container. Now the started container can be stopped. So here you can see, if you wanted to restart, then it will get stopped and it will start again. Docker rm command will actually remove that container from the list. Okay, so if you see, you can create the container from the image or can be from the Docker file. If your image is already there, you just do a Docker run, it will create the container. If you have a Docker file, you create the image and you get the container. So here is the flow. So if you wanted to restart, then this will get stopped and that will get started, right? Now, what if I am killing the Docker? So Docker restart will die, restart and restart. Docker pose will pose the container, all the containers, and Docker and pose will unpose them, okay? There is out of memory also will be there in the Docker, like Docker is not getting enough memory. So killed by out of memory, OOM, and in Docker process will die. Okay, So this is the process life cycle of a Docker or the containers which we are creating in the system. Okay. So Docker pull MySQL. MySQL image is not there locally, so it will pull that image. So we can just run this simple command. If you wanted to pull the image and run it, Docker run MySQL. It will pull the MySQL image and it will run that MySQL image. Then you can spin up all these methods, Docker start, stop, restart images and all. Okay. Now we'll talk about, we'll create a containers for the actual development environment from the next video.